Hi, Pisces. Welcome to your bonus read for the week. I'm going to be taking a look at the person on your mind and why they're being distant with you. Now, I'm going to pull three cards to start, clarify each card to give us some more insight. And at the end of your reading, I'm going to pull three messages plus one bonus message from this person of what they're holding back from telling you. Now, this is general and it may not resonate for everyone. If it does, go ahead and hit that like button. If you haven't already, subscribe to my channels. It helps me to pick up on your energy for all future reads. Please remember that time is fluid, so this could be something that happened in your past, currently in your present, or coming up in your future. Now let's go ahead and jump right in. The person on Pisces' mind, show me why they're being distant with Pisces. Pisces, this person has been waiting to tell you that they want to shift in a different direction. Seven of Pentacles, Two of Pentacles, the Fool, and the Emperor is at the bottom of the deck. I do have Aries, Aquarius, Capricorn, and Taurus energy that comes out so far. So Seven of Pentacles, that Two of Pentacles, and the Fool, you know, they are waiting. They've been looking at the situation and they feel that it's going backwards. We're going from the Seven of Pentacles and they feel like they're going down to a Two of Pentacles. Like you two might not really know each other that well anymore, or, you know, it's not progressing further. They feel like it's backsliding. And that's where it makes them feel like they want to take a leap of faith in a different direction, that it would just be the right thing to do. That they don't want to stay in a situation where they feel that either you or them or the both of you have put this wall up and these boundaries between getting to know each other or move to the next step between the two of you. And that just, they're like, I don't know what to do. But they've been juggling back and forth and waiting for the right time to just say, I don't think this is working. So they're distancing themselves to kind of compile how they're going to approach the situation. So let's go ahead and clarify that Seven of Pentacles. That card. So they feel like they've lost some of their independence in this situation with you. At one point they felt very independent and some of that has been taken away. They feel like they've been a little codependent. Now if that's you've been codependent on them, that's not, they feel like things are getting stagnant and boring and it's just not working out. They want to go back to being single. They want to go back to just doing their own thing and being super independent, but feeling that it's hard to do that whenever you two are getting so far in this situation with trying to grow a relationship here. And they want that. I get like you share bank accounts together as well for some of you. So there's really that joint dependency on one another because your money is tied up together. And they just feel like things are just really stagnant. Really, you know, I just feel like it's boring. It's not going anywhere. I don't know what to do. I don't know how to fix this. And that kind of situation that comes out here. And I do have Cancer as well as Virgo energy that comes out. Let's go ahead and clarify that Two of Pentacles. Yeah, the Emperor coming out in a 50-50 energy. They're finding it very difficult to actually tell you. See, they're weighing back and forth of what do I do? There's too many walls between the two of us. I don't want to fight. I don't want this to turn into a bad situation. I just feel like I don't know if I can make that move to really tell Pisces how I feel or say what's on my mind or that things are not progressing forward. And it's making me feel very vulnerable. It's making me not feel like myself and I don't know what to do. So it's very challenging for them to really progress forward and find a way to work things out and create a balance here because of how much of the situation does not feel like they can just open up and talk to you freely. They're feeling like there's some boundaries that if they open up and say certain things, it would be really crossing the boundaries into creating fights and drama and aggression between the two of you, and not wanting to do that. So Aries energy as well as Leo that comes out here. Let's go ahead and clarify the Fool. The Fool is clarified by the Lovers as well as the Queen of Swords at the bottom of the deck. Wanting a fresh new start, and could be with somebody else. You know, there is the sense of somebody else really coming into their life and liking them and wanting a relationship. The thing about it is Pisces is their heart is not open to that new person, just so you know. Their heart is closed off to somebody else new, but they do want a fresh new start to figure out what it is that they want in a relationship or what they want as far as unions and relationships. But they're not looking to just date or be with someone right away. Their heart is feeling closed off to that. It feels like the relationship and union comes to, I want to be independent. I want to experience this on my own. I want to figure it out. And, you know, I want to plant my flag where it's supposed to go in the world and claim things as mine. This is mine. I made it happen all on my own. Because the Queen of Swords is definitely somebody who is very much independent, makes her own money, doesn't necessarily need another partner or a partner at all because she feels like she's got it all on her own. And when people try to approach her, she's like, no, thanks. I'm good. She's hard to read at times, but this is just where they want to start things. They want to have that fresh new beginning, you know, to rediscover what unions, you know, mean to them. And when it comes to somebody else, their heart's not open to somebody else, even though there is somebody new that really likes them and wants them. But just know they're not open to being with somebody else in that way. At least not now. So we have Gemini, Aquarius, Libra energy that came out. Let's get some messages from this person. What are they holding back from telling Pisces? Okay, everything came out really quick. So they feel like you are their soulmate. But that things are just not progressing forward. They're actually backsliding, and that's making them feel like you two are at this crossroads that's very, very difficult, and it's hard to talk about things. And there's so many boundaries that can't be crossed without it causing some kind of drama or fight. But the first thing that comes out is absence. I feel like a part of me is missing without you. Okay. And that's where that, you know, that codependence on you in a sense of, you know, you have part of this person's heart and their soul, and that's what they feel. Without you, it feels like they're missing that completion of something within them. However, they don't know how to fix this. So space, I need more time to think, especially since they feel that things have been shifting in a different direction between the two of you. I hope that you two can talk about this if that's what you want. If not, you know, you do whatever you feel is necessary for your situation and what's best for your emotional growth, you know, and your overall happiness and theirs as well. So runner, I don't want to run anymore. You know, they don't want to run from things anymore. They want to talk things out. They want to figure it out. However, it's difficult to really bring certain things up without it creating some kind of argument. So soul tie, I always feel connected to you, even when they're not with you, especially since things have been going from, okay, things are growing, they're getting great, and now it's changed, and I feel like we're backsliding, and I don't know what to do, how do I fix this, and it's been making them reflect on, do I want to stay in this situation, because I feel like we're just getting bored with each other, do we have anything else left? And that's where they're like, no, I still, you know, I still feel this connection to Pisces. I still miss them. I feel like part of me is with them, you know, but there's also some self-love at the bottom of the deck right here. I'm still trying to heal. You know, this person has some wounds that are very deep within their life, and it doesn't have to be from past relationships of romantic relationships, but they're trying to heal some parts of themselves that, you know, they find to be like that make them feel insecure, very vulnerable, and lead them to things are wrong whenever something doesn't go, I guess, a certain way. Maybe they like to have control of certain situations to always feel happy, but they're trying to really gain more self-love and heal certain wounds that are very deep within them. The loss of someone close to them, the wounds that they had from maybe their childhood, could be another romantic relationship, you know, losing friends, moving on in the world, whatever the case may be, things shifting and changing in their life, they feel a sense of loss, and that makes them feel vulnerable, and then there's some wounds there. Also, maybe the things that have happened in their childhood all the way to their adulthood that they never really gave it a moment to look at it and realize that it does affect them deeply, and it makes them start to question certain things about themselves, about people, about, you know, relationships. And they used to run from relationships because they didn't want to get hurt, or they didn't want to feel the loss of someone else again because that hurts greatly. But needing some more time to think, space everything, they're going to come around. They're just trying to, like I said, compile a way of, how do I approach Pisces about this? How do we talk about these things? The things that are really affecting the both of us and make me feel like we're constantly juggling between work and not spending time together, or, you know, how do I make it sound like I'm not too needy? So this is what I have for you, Pisces. If it resonates, go ahead and hit that like button. I will see you in your next reading coming up. Have a good rest of your day. Bye.